While the Nets roster has quite a few sharp dressers, there's one that stands out above the rest. Veteran forward, DeMarre Carroll.
Well, that's an animal outfit right there.
Those were
DeMarre Carroll.
That's a lot of cats.
You're known as a veteran, a tough guy, all the dirty work for a team. Off the court, you're known for the fashion.
Yeah.
And let's go back to Alabama. Did you always have an interest in fashion?
Always. I think my mom really put the fashion in me. When I was in kindergarten, she used to have me sweatsuits, matching sweatsuits with the Reebok pumps. And she always had me looking good. With, always take me to the barbershop to make sure I get a edge up. So she always been a fashion person. I think it just kept growing. So what I got.
And that feeling of like, it's like the first day of school, laying stuff out.
I used to lay it out, you know, look at it about 3-4 times, put it on, take it back off. So I always been like that. Now, I still do it, but it comes a little easier now, you know, so.
Yeah, what was the, do you remember the first piece of clothing that you fell in love with?
My first, I'm telling you, I used to be on the sweatsuit game. Like, I used to just, and I think we used to get it from, like, Walmart, but it was matching. But I used to always have nice shoes, and she used to always say, you make a statement with your shoes and your accessories. So I used to have really nice shoes, and, you know, she might put a little watch on me or something like that. I remember I had a thin necklace my mom used to put on me, so it carried over now.
How would you describe your fashion style? How would you describe it?
I think I'm a little out there. You know, I'm a little out there. I'm definitely got that Southern matching. I'm always matching. That's one thing. I haven't got to the West Coast with the, you know, not matching type thing. But I'm always matching. But I'm a little bit out there. I try to match it according to my skin tone, you know. I want it all to look great.
It's got to pop. Got to pop. How does living in Brooklyn influence your fashion style?
Great. You know, it's probably fashion capital of the world or something, you know. Just being here, you know, seeing different types of fashion, you know, going to a lot of the stores out here, it's been great for me, for my brand. Not too well for my pockets, but it's definitely well for my brand.
Are you a runway guy? You check out New York Fashion Week?
Yeah, you know, runway. I love all those types of things. Like my wife says, she don't like going shopping with me because it's a 5-6 hour process.
5-6 hours?
Yeah, for sure. I got to try everything. I got to make sure it fits. You know, I just can't go in there and say, give me this, give me that. Because different materials have different fit. So, and I'm big on, like, the material and all the fabric and all of those types of things.
Is this all in one spot, or is it 5-6 hours bouncing around at different spots?
I'm about 3 in Dolce, and then we might fall off in some boutiques, but Dolce & Gabbana is definitely my spot.
Definitely
my home, yeah.
Is there someone that you would one day love to collaborate with for a fashion line?
Actually, I'm finna get ready to collab with one of the top designers in Canada named Christopher Bates. We've been in talks, but it's on the lookout.
Okay, any details?
I can't really give too much detail, but we definitely try and get into that. We're going to have some in the fashion show next year.